class session two of the week. We are going to go ahead and get started with our warm-up. A little bit different on the warm-up today, so we're just going to go ahead and start with kneeling side bends. Make sure that we're sitting up or kneeling tall. Big breathing here. Alright, chest expansion. And cat and cow. Alright, seated position. I'm going to go ahead and do our leg circles today in a seated position. So, actual hip circles with this bent leg here. So, hands are down. I'm just going to slightly lean back, keep this knee bent, warming up. Small circles, keeping the leg bent. Reverse. Switch legs. And reverse. And down for your 100. Legs all the way up. Slightly lower those legs and go ahead and begin. Alright, so when you're ready, we're going to start our single leg exercise, a bent leg, single leg drop. So, we've done this before. We're going to start with our knees in. So, we're going to bring one knee in for the stretch and leg drop here. So, switch, scooping, chin to chest.
So next will be our double leg drop. Same thing as the first exercise. We're just going to keep that leg bent and we're just dropping both feet down.
Okay. Knees in, head and shoulders up. And we're just simply going to lower the feet and lift the knees in. Gently pull.
Crisscross will work one leg at a time today. So one leg is doing the work, the other leg is static, and we'll keep that leg bent just to go with the theme of the bent leg exercises today. So I'm still crossing over, but I'm only coming back to center and going, repeating and going the same direction each time. So go ahead and bring your hands behind your neck today. Keeping this one foot on the floor, I'm just simply going to pull this knee in, come across, and then I'm going to bring it back down. So I'm not extending the leg, I'm just keeping it bent. Still rotating across and scooping. And switch legs. Last one. And rest. A single straight will be just traditional, and so we'll double straight. So we'll just go one at a time. So go ahead and bring both legs up, head and shoulders up, single straight, gentle pull on the back of the leg. Scooping, chin to chest, big breathing here. So this probably feels really good because we've had our leg bent up until now. And rest. Double straight, both legs down, both legs up. Our hands are behind our neck. So go ahead and bring both legs all the way up, head and shoulders up, hands behind your neck, and drop. Exhale on the drop. And rest. All right, so our bridge work, we did this last week, I believe, with the clam at the top. So go ahead and bring your feet a little bit closer together. And you're going to keep your knees close together as we lift our hips up off the ground. And then at the top, we're just going to part the legs for clam. And then come on down. So we're just going to keep our arms at our sides here. Go ahead and lift, part, pull together, and down. Up, out, together, and down. Up, out, in, and down. One more. Up, out, in, and down. Good. All right. Let's go ahead and bring our legs all the way down and arms all the way back. Now remember, if you cannot do a straight leg roll up, full arm sweep, you can slightly bend those knees and assist yourself up if you'd like, okay? You can start with your arms at your sides if you'd like. It's up to you. Otherwise, if you just need a little bit of help, assistance with the arm sweep, you can create a little bit of momentum to lift yourself up, but we still want to connect that low back to the mat and pelvic floor muscles are engaged. So nothing is sacrificed, even though we are sweeping our arms a little bit quicker, okay? Straight legs, arms back, and roll up. Slowly come down, connect that back, staying scooped. One more roll up and finish at the top. Okay. All right,
So our spine twist, a little different today. We're going to keep our hands behind our neck. So we're going to sit up tall. I want you to slightly part your legs though. So the move is a little bit different and the leg position is different, as well as the hand position. So sitting up tall, hands are behind my neck. I am going to twist slightly and then lean slightly forward, kind of like saw. And then I'm going to slightly twist in the opposite direction and lean slightly. So just alternating between the directions, trying to keep our back nice and flat. I'm going to open my twist up just a little bit more each time. Start to notice the flexibility or the limbering up of that lumbar region, that low back. Good. And back to start. Go ahead and front stretch. Okay, so normally with stomach massage, we hold our legs with our feet. Today we're going to try holding our legs up without our hands. So we're going to place our hands down at our sides, bring my knees in to start. I'm rounded here, and I'm simply going to open up in a V position. So my back is flat, my legs are straight, and I'm closing in and opening up. In and up, in, out, in, out, in, and out. Good. All right, so we have rolling like a ball, except now we are going to go ahead and part our knees. I want you to bring your hands underneath your calves here. So the same exercise, same movement, except just a little bit of a different knee and hand position. So we're developing this exercise into what's going to be called open leg rocker. From rolling like a ball to open leg rocker. One more. Good. All right. Come on back with your elbows. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and keep one foot on the ground and one leg extended. So this extended leg is going to do the work. And I'm simply going to elevate this leg here. And remember, rib cage is nice and high, chest is high. And I'm going to bend my knee and bring my knee out to the side and forward towards your trunk. So back to straight leg, pull it in and out. So you're going to feel this in the inner thigh, hip. We won't do many. Legs, elevate, pull, bend, and open the hip. Last one. All right, come ahead. Let's come up. Into spine stretch. Legs are in V position. Big stretch over the top. Good. ahead and bring your legs over to your side for mermaid. So today we'll do presentation arm. I'm not sure if I've done this with you. It's just a little bit different with where our arm goes from that reach over. So starting same move as we always do with mermaid, over the top, hand down, arm over. And from here, I'm going to lean forward and rotate my arm out. And then I'm going to sweep back over the top and begin again. So it's a reach over and a reach across. Back. Over. Slightly lean forward. One more. Over. And out. Good. Go ahead and switch your legs. So again, this exercise, we want to make sure we maintain control of our movement. No unnecessary speed or pace improvements or increases. We're just being consistent with our pace. Muscles get used to this pace, the movement. There's no abrupt change. Last one. Good. All right, knee hug, center yourself before we turn over. Turn over onto your tummies. Today we have a Superman exercise. It's a little bit changed, a little bit modified. So we're gonna lift and sweep our arms back, and when my arms and my legs are lifted, as I sweep my arms back, I'm going to begin flutter kicking. Okay, so let me demonstrate this. So my arms are extended, leading my head here. I'm going to lift like Superman, and when I start to sweep my arms back, I'm going to kick. Arms back to front, stop kicking, and lower the legs and the arms. All right, let's try this. Ready? Lift up, sweep and kick. Stop. And lower. And lift. Sweep and kick. And down. One more. Up. Sweep, kick. And down. Good. All right, come up onto your elbows. Bring your hips up. I want you to come up and bring your knees up. And we're going to roll the hips side to side. All right, knees down. Come on back for low back stretch. All right, from this position, we're going to come down to modified push-up position. So go ahead and come on down to your mat, hands outside your chest. All right, so from this position, I'm going to bend my knees. So keeping my knees bent, I'm going to push up. From here, extending my feet down to the mat, high plank, lift one foot slightly off the floor, and we're shifting our weight back on the heel, switch feet, shifting, feet down, knees down, legs up, come on down. All right, here we go. Up, feet down, high plank, one foot, shifts, other foot, shifts, knees down, legs up, and down. All right, one more time and then we're going to finish at the top. Here we go. Up, feet, shift, shift, knees down. Woo! All right, so front split. I'm not sure if we've done this before, but I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate this. This is a hip mobility stretch. So dynamic, but we're really focusing on hip mobility here. We're going to go ahead and bring our hands down to the mat and table. And I'm going to go ahead and bring one foot forward. And I'm going to keep this knee down on the ground. And I want to make sure that when I position myself to start, that my hands are right outside my lead foot here, okay? I'm going to transfer my weight forward so my hips are down, keeping my foot down on the ground. And I'm gonna transfer my weight back, not changing the position of my hands really too much. And my toes are gonna come up and my front leg is going to straighten slightly. And I'm going to hold my weight on this back bent leg here and lower my chest to my leg to get a nice big stretch through the back of the leg. I'm going to transfer my weight forward, push the hip down, foot down, transfer my weight back, toes up, chest down, forward, and back. Good. We're going to switch legs. Again, find that starting position. Hands outside the foot. Lead foot here. Transfer the weight forward. Hips down. And back. Toes up. Start to straighten the leg, lower the chest, or keep the chest connected to the thigh. Weight forward. And back. And forward. And back. One more. Forward. And back. Bring this foot back, kneeling tall. Heel touches today. So remember, that's just a slight rotation as we lean back. So go ahead and bring your arms to your sides. Remember, one unit. I am leaning back and slightly rotating to touch the heel. Leaning forward, back to start. Other side, leaning back. Touch the heel, back to start. All right, we're going to come into table position for dog kick exercise. So these are pulses. So I'm going to extend my left leg down or out and I'm going to extend my right arm out. And from here, I'm going to lift both my leg and my arm and pulse at the top. Trying to stay centered in my trunk. Abdominals are pulled in. Breathing. And down. Switch leg and switch arm. Extend out. Lift and pulse. And down, switch again. And down, switch again. And table and low back stretch. Arms back at your sides. Come on down to your side, all the way down. Go ahead and bend your knees and keep your feet connected, hand out in front for balance. We're going to work on clams, okay? So it's going to be a mini lift because our arm is all the way down. So our hip can only open up so much, okay? With our hip connected to the mat. So, keeping the feet connected, we're lifting up and down, up and down. You feel that outer hip doing the work. Hip abductors working here. All right, now come up onto your elbow. And I want you to go ahead and bring this foot back and extend this bottom leg. And we are going to lift this leg straight up. And we're going to just go ahead and put this hand on the knee. And we're lifting, keeping our foot flexed so it's nice and strong. Your knees. All right, we have our crosses. So I'm going to lift my hips, lift my arm, and my hips will come back as I rotate under my armpit. Hips come forward, arm up. Stay up here. Cross, lift, cross, lift. Lift, one more, cross under, lift up, good. All right, switch sides, all the way down. Knees bent, feet connected, clams. On your elbow, straight leg, hand on knee, flex the foot, and lift. One more. And bend those knees again, crosses, lift the hips up, arm up, hips back, arm down. tag. So we're going to begin again. We're going to double up on some exercises. Still pretty much the same. Crisscross will be a little different this time through. So we'll start with our bent leg, single leg drop, and then we'll go into that bent leg, double leg drop. Okay? So go ahead and come on down, bring your knees with you, keeping the legs bent. We're going to go ahead and drop one leg for singles. Breathing, really focusing on connecting the breathing with the movement. Second time through. We're going to turn this into double leg. Both knees in. Legs drop. Knees in. And rest. Good. All right, so we have our single leg crisscross. That means one leg is doing the work. We'll just practice this solo, and then we will combine the next two exercises, okay? So the only difference is the first time we kept this leg bent. The second time through, we're going to pull it in and extend it out, but we're keeping this foot grounded, okay? All right, let's go ahead and lift the head and shoulders up, pull the knee in and rotate back to center, extend the leg out. We've done this before. Last one. Good. And rest. All right, so we have two back to back. It's our traditional single straight, double straight. Okay? So we'll go back to back, no rest in between if you can. Both legs all the way up, head and shoulders up, and single straight. Gentle pull. Turn this into double straight, both legs up, hands behind the neck, drop those legs together, focus on your exhale, one more. And feet down. Good. Arms down. Feet a little bit closer together. So we have our bridge clamps. Knees stay together. Here we go. Lift up and out and in and down. Up, out, and one more, up, out, in, down. Go ahead and knee hug just to release some tension in the back. before we go into our roll up. All right, just like before, if you can do a straight leg, full arm sweep roll up, I want you to practice this. Otherwise, bend your knees and assist yourself. Here we go, ready, up. Focus on your exhale lifting. One more, finish at the top. And seated tall. Slight part of the legs. We have that spine twist. With our hands behind our neck. So we're twisting, leaning, twisting, leaning. That stomach massage with hands down. So we're scooping and opening. One more. Okay. Rolling like a ball with hands underneath the calves with an open leg position just slightly. One leg bent, one leg straight. The straight leg does the work. Lift the rib cage, lift the leg, pull the knee in and out. Spine stretch, V position. Remember to lead with your chest, big stretch,
big exhale over the top.
Mermaid, legs to your side with presentation arm, so that's just that opening. Go ahead and begin. and slow it down. Switch your legs. So we're going to turn over and we're going to practice the Superman lift and then the arm sweep back simultaneous coordinated with the flutter kicks. Alright, here we go. We're lifting, sweep and kick, and down. Up. And down. Up. And down. One more. Elbows, hips up, knees up, hip rolls, knees down. Low back stretch. So that next exercise is that modified push-up, and that leg lift shifting. So you're also in that leg curl position, so the legs are up. So come on down. Hands outside your chest. Legs are curled. Push up. Legs down. Leg up. Shift. Leg down. Leg up. Shift. Foot down. Knees down. Legs in. Push up. Repeat. One more. And finish at the top after this. We'll go into table position. Good. All right, front split. Foot forward. Transferring our weight forward. Hips down. Transferring the weight back. Toes up. Straight leg. Lean forward. Switch. Transfer position here. Switch. through, right back. One more time, forward. And back. Switch legs. Remember, find this position with the hands just outside that lead foot. Hips down. Back, kneeling tall. Heel touches here. Arms outstretched. Weight back. One more each side. All right, table position, dog kick pulses. Extend your left leg back, right arm forward, lift and pulse at the top. Switch. And switch. And low back stretch. Arms back at your sides. All right, so we're gonna come on down to our lying side clams. Go all the way down, hand behind your neck. Legs are bent, keeping our feet connected. We're in a clam here. And come up on our elbow, bent leg back, bottom leg straight, go ahead and flex that foot, hand on knee, and we're lifting. All right, bend those legs again. Crosses, lift the hips up, arm up, cross under, hips back. Push hips forward, arm up. One more. And switch sides. Traffic in my living room right now. Come all the way down. Clams. And up on our elbow. Lower leg lifts. bend your knees, hips up, arm up, crosses. Seated accordions. You're almost done. So we're going to try a new arm exercise. It's actually three exercises in one. It's more dynamic. It's the only exercise we will finish with. All right, go ahead and sit up tall, legs extended. So we're going to start with our pullbacks, which we have normally done in the past. And we're going to pull our elbows back to our sides with our elbows down. From this position, the second move is going to be lifting our elbows up. So our arms, forearms are parallel to the floor. The third move is the extension of the arms forward. Okay, so that's the third move. So we're gonna start, pull, squeeze the shoulder blades, lift, extend, pull, control your breathing. We're going to butterfly. So keeping our feet together, we're going to bend our knees, and we're just going to lean in towards our butterfly position here. You should start to feel those inner thighs recovering, returning back to their normal state, so stretching. Bring the knees in. Extend one leg out, pull this other leg across and towards you, outer thigh, outer hip, stretch here. Switch legs, cross, bend, and pull. All right, you guys, we are done. So I will see you next session. Let's see. It'll be session 3. And gosh, we're getting really close to the end. So hopefully you're feeling good, and I'll see you next time.